by the kids' needlework you've been meaning to frame. This fall, why not bring them into the framing workshop and let us get to work on them? At the framing workshop, we specialize in framing all those I'll get around to it projects, and we do them up exquisitely. While you're in, see our great art-related gifts, but be sure to visit us soon at the framing workshop at Barclay Square.
Unless you're a travel professional, you can't always know all there is to know about airfares, seasonal rates, package tours, and other details behind a successful trip. That's why you should see the travel professionals at South Georgia Travel. South Georgia Travel has served the travel needs of our area since 1964, and we're dedicated to offering the quality travel services you deserve. Call 244-2324 or stop by our offices on Baytree Road. It'll be our pleasure to serve you.
We're in the pregame from Cleveland Field. John Lastinger along with Mike Chasen, minutes away from kickoff. Beautiful day for football. Not actually a beautiful day, but if you're a football player, you got to like it. A little overcast and cool and have a little bounce in the legs today. We're talking about Chris Hatcher and what a player he is, has become for this Blazer offense, certainly last year, and then has really just put up some impressive numbers. And as we, the Blazer Sports Information Department putting out each week, the Hatcher Watch, and let's go down the list here and then just talk a little bit about what he has accomplished thus far. You talk about, you can go last week, first of all, he had some record-setting performance in the loss to West Georgia. Most pass attempts, 61. Most pass completions, 45. Both of those school records. He's got the most consecutive completions in a game. That was 17 versus Delta State a year ago. The most yards, 424. That was against West Georgia last week. The most plays, 61 versus West Georgia last week. Longest touchdown pass came earlier in the year against Central Florida of 90 yards. Most passes without an interception in a ball game was last year, ironically, against Mississippi College. He threw 47 passes without an interception. Career, let's look at that. Most completions, 552. Most attempts, 849. He's thrown 56 touchdown passes. Career passing yardage, 5,589. He passed Ty Cottle last week in the West Georgia game. And most total offensive yards, 5,789. So those are some of the records that that he's got. And in the list, just right on continues, Mike. He's got some of the conference records that he already holds. The last week's 45 completions versus West Georgia was the record. We told you about the 17 straight against Delta State last year. The most passes without an interception, 47 versus Mississippi College. That's a conference record already. This season, he's on pace to break even more conference records, 26 completions per game if he keeps up at the pace he's going. So most touchdown passes, 26 is a conference record. And most passes without being intercepted, 177. So you really can't find enough. I mean, we could take the whole afternoon to talk about some of the things he's accomplished, but I think probably the most important thing is he's just a great student athlete that represents this conference, represents this school, and deserves just about every honor that he's got coming his way.
A great football player, a great young gentleman. John and I have had the opportunity to get to know Chris just a little bit, and he's been called Opie, he's been called the baby face. He is quite a young gentleman, and always a gentleman, we emphasize that word, but a great football player as well. We're going to take a 90-second network break. When we return, we'll have Coach Al Mummy in the BSU Blazers. We'll be back in 90 seconds. This is the Blazer Sports Network.
It's happening in the smallest towns, in the youngest communities, in the most out-of-the-way places. People throughout the nation are discovering the borrowing advantages of living in a major financial center because they live in one of the communities served by Nations Bank, a bank that provides Greg McCormick in Albany, Georgia, all the financing he could ever need, and gives families like the Reams in Sarasota, Florida, the latest in equity lines of credit. Nations Bank offers every person the widest range of lending options, from customized home improvement loans to tax-smart auto loans with savings that can be of great interest. So whether you live in the smallest town, the biggest city, or any of 1,900 other communities throughout our nation, there's only one source for loans. Nations Bank, the loan source.
Equal housing lender, credit subject to approval, consult your tax advisor.
Prepare. Prepare yourself for an extraordinary new rotisserie chicken, deeply marinated with herbs and spices, then slowly roasted till golden brown. Is it from KFC? Indeed. The legendary long-lost recipe only at KFC. Taste it and believe. The new Colonel's Rotisserie Gold. At KFC, we do chicken right. Available only at participating KFC restaurants.
We're talking with Coach Al Mumme, the Valdosta State University Blazers, on a Saturday afternoon, kind of a gloomy Saturday afternoon, which can be brightened quite a bit if the Blazers pull out a big Gulf South Conference win this afternoon over the Choctaws of Mississippi College. Choctaws coming here 4-1-1, a team that's on probation this year, but a team that's out on a mission of vengeance. The Blues Brothers were on a mission from God. Well, the Choctaws are on a mission from Clinton, Mississippi. They want to win as many Gulf South Conference games as they can. And, Coach, they're a tough bunch to deal with for a probation year.
Well, like I told our kids this morning, they kept us from going to the playoffs 2 years ago. We tied them for the second time in the game, and they picked them instead of us. Those guys had 98 guys in scholarship, and they're supposed to have 40. So, that vengeance stuff works both ways.
Good point there. The Blazers, of course, coming off a loss on Saturday night in Carrollton. What was the attitude in practice this week, Coach? Maybe pick it up. Let's go get them.
Yeah, it was serious, Mike. They got after it. We'll play hard enough.
Winning out, everybody says we got to win the last four if we expect to get in the playoffs. Do you agree with that assessment?
Well, there's a lot of football to be played. I think a lot of them will be determined up there at Central Arkansas today between them and North Alabama. Central Arkansas got a good team. Some of it depends on what happens there and what happens the rest of the way. But, yeah, you got to win the conference. And the only way to do that is win the rest of them.
How about this Mississippi College team? What do we expect from them offensively? What do you think they're going to do?
Well, they're going to try to run the ball about two times every time they throw it. But they're pretty balanced. They try to be fairly balanced. And they're rushing for about 240 yards a game. They're throwing for about 140 or 50, something like that. So, they got a good offense. They got some good skill kids. Their quarterback's an excellent player. Their tailbacks are great players. They got a big old tight end. They got a wide receiver and really catch. So we got our hands full.
How about defensively? How do we match up against them size-wise? Are we about the same or what?
It's basically the same team we faced last year, except they've got the free safety number 7 back. He was on their national championship team, and he sat out a year or two, I think, and he's back. So he's a pretty good player.
Injury-wise, how do we feel this afternoon on this rainy Saturday homecoming afternoon?
Well, we're in pretty good shape. We've got David Ashby, our punter, sustained a sprained foot and kind of a freak deal in practice, but he's punted well in warm-ups, but he'd be the guy you guys probably need to watch the most. See how he does.
Coach, we're pulling for you for a homecoming victory in front of all the alumni in the rain on Saturday afternoon at Cleveland Field as we get ready for these final four Gulf South Conference games. Like nothing better than to win out and win four in a row and sneak right into those playoffs for the first time in 12 years of VSU football. Pulling for you this afternoon. Thank you, Mike. Al Mumme and the VSU Blazers will be back after this 90-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
This is Mark Bosch. Oftentimes, people get the notion that the only way to get the best deal on a new vehicle is to drive hundreds of miles out of town. Now, at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, we make this pledge to our customers. We will meet or beat any competitor's price for a new Oldsmobile, Buick, GMC truck, or new Isuzu. Now you can be assured without trips to Jacksonville, Tallahassee, or wherever, you'll get the best deal at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu. On any model, any day, any time. Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, North Valdosta Road.
We're in the store once again here at Nijem's Diamonds and Gold. And fellas, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
That's right, Bob. We're geared up for it.
We got a lot of merchandise.
Right now, we have a large diamond sale and a gold sale going on. We have a 1-carat tennis bracelet for just $1.99.
We have a 2-carat diamond, ruby, sapphire, and emerald bracelet for $1.99.
And that means at Nijem's, you can put anything on layaway and layaway now for Christmas.
Nijem Diamonds and Gold.
Nijem's Diamonds and Gold, Valdosta and Lake Park.
It's such a pleasant surprise to shop at the Framing Workshop. Hello, this is Carla Penny from the Framing Workshop, here to remind you of all the exquisite things we have to offer that you might not think about for a frame shop. We have hand-carved pens and boxes, clocks and journals, gift books, miniature gardens, and the most outstanding collection of photo frames for your tabletops that you'll ever see. Get your Hallusion 3D images here, too. The Framing Workshop at Barclay Square by the mall.
is Bart Bosch. Oftentimes, people get the notion that the only way to get the best deal on a new vehicle is to drive hundreds of miles out of town. Now, at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, we make this pledge to our customers. We will meet or beat any competitor's price for a new Oldsmobile, Buick, GMC truck, or new Isuzu. Now you can be assured without trips to Jacksonville, Tallahassee, or wherever, you'll get the best deal at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu on any model, any day, any time. Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, North Valdosta Road.
We're in the store once again here at Nijum's Diamonds and Gold. And fellas, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
That's right, Bob. We're geared up for it.
We got a lot of merchandise.
Right now, we have a large diamond sale and a gold sale going on. We have a 1-carat tennis bracelet for just $199.
We have a 2-carat diamond, ruby, sapphire, and emerald bracelet for $199.
And that means at Nijum's, you can put anything on layaway and layaway now for Christmas.
Nijum Diamonds and Gold.
Nijum's Diamonds and Gold, Valdosta and Lake Park.
Believe in, send me somebody.
gonna sing it to my friends. I've got a song, I ain't got no melody. I'm gonna sing it to my friends. When I go round in circles, when they fly high like a bird up there.
Mike Chasen and John Lastinger back live from Cleveland Field in Valdosta, Georgia. We're back on the air. We had a momentary lapse there, but they're having a lapse on the field as well. But we're just about ready for the kickoff here. Valdosta State University and Mississippi College. The Choctaws from Clinton, Mississippi, and the Blazers of Valdosta State. It's homecoming 1993, and the white shirts are going to kick off to the left into your radio dial, and the black shirts all in black today. Back in black in 93, the Blazers of Hal Mumme. And standing back at the goal line is Blake Duncan. Here's the kickoff. We're underway. Gulf South Conference NCAA Division II action. Duncan's going to take it to 3, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Burst out of there to 30, 32, 33, 36-yard line. Blake Duncan with a tremendous return on this Saturday afternoon. The Blazers are going to set up shop at the 36-yard line. Great return that time by the senior, Blake Duncan.
Yeah, I like to not to go with the Texas return, so... Blake just a standard return right up the middle of the gut there and found a little seam there and good second effort, got it up to the 35. Nice start for the Blazers.
Here's Chris Hatcher, the ready record-setting quarterback for Hal Mumme's team. He's going to face a four-man front. Now they're going to sneak one other man along the line, two down linemen. Here's Hatch under the center. Got a motion man to this side. It's Pender. He's going to throw quickly to Pender at the 33, to the 35, barely gets to the 36-yard line, right back at the line of scrimmage. The man who made the stop for Mississippi College, the Choctaws, Richard Myers, the senior defensive end from Hattiesburg. He was the Gulf South Conference Defensive Player of the Week last week, had quite an outing against 1AA foe Samford. As a matter of fact, 17 tackles.
Well, he's got 69 on the year, Mike, so he leads the team. He's a big play, big hitter for that Choctaw defense.
Here's Hatch under the center. Got two men split behind him. Got one man on the right side, two wideouts on the left. Audibilizing at the line of scrimmage. Four-man front for the white shirts from Clinton. Motion man is Steve Greer. Caught 12 balls last week. Hatch is looking for Greer over the middle. Now he looks left side. Got his man, Calvin Walker. Drops the football on the far side at the 37-yard line. It will be third and 9 yards to go for the Blazers of Valdosta State.
Good play by the Choctaw defense. What we're seeing about what we expected, and that's a two-deep safety with basically a five underneath zone, and have done it both times and run it successfully. That time Chris Hatcher looked to his right, tried to find Steve Greer on that side, but ended up going all the way back across the field to his left side.
Here's Hatch in the shotgun this time. Got Blake Duncan on his right side. Three receivers on the left. Lyman all preparing for pass blocking. Three going to rush this time for the white shirts from Clinton. Here's Hatch. Three-step drop. Looking left side. Got Duncan over here. Goes to his left. Goes to his right instead. And got Reginald Walker. He'll be tackled right at the line of scrimmage. Blazers are going to have to kick it away. We'll take a second here for our stations along the Blazer Sports Network to identify themselves. This is the Blazer Sports Network.
Star 105 is WSTI-FM. Quitman, Valdosta Lake Park, and Orb Communications Station.
After an outstanding kickoff return by Blake Duncan, the Blazers are not able to move the ball 1 inch. Here's the Ashby with the punt, a very high punt. Remember, he's bothered by that injury. A catch call for it to 25, and he's going to run out of there to the 30, 35, 37-yard line. Looked like he'd called for a fair catch, and then he decided to run with it. And the man who brought it out was Ben Sanford, the sophomore from Meridian, Mississippi. Good field position now in exactly the same location at the other end of the field for the Choctaws of Mississippi College.
Boy, it really looked like number 34 for the Blazers, Reggie West, hustling down there, almost like he got a clip there in the back, pushed him by, but nice return for the Choctaws, and they'll start up with good field position on their initial drive.
Had some problems with the clock early. Those problems continue. One clock shows 12:59, the other one shows 12:12. High backfield for the Choctaws. Motion man to the visitor side of the stadium. Under the center, going to hand off first man through. Rambles off the right tackle position and gains maybe a yard on the play. And the Blazers are going to stack him up there. Man who carried the football for the visitors from Clinton, the big fullback that time, and able to gain maybe a yard on the play, was Jay Bourne, the senior from Columbia, Mississippi. It'll be second and 10, second and 9.5, call it. Second and 9.5 at the 36.5-yard line. Don't know how much time left in the first quarter. We do know no score on the board for either team, the Choctaws or the Blazers.
Mike, we didn't have a chance to talk much in the pregame show, but Mike Berry is back playing after three games out with a shoulder injury. He is back and in the lineup. We didn't expect him to start, but he's right there, right tackle for the Blazers.
Under the center this time on second and 9.5. Going to go straight ahead looking for room, finding it, and then knocked down at the 41-yard line. Good pursuit by George Parsons. Got his arms wrapped around him and finally wrestled him down. Got some help from the black shirts. The man who carried the football for the visitors was Kevin Blackman. Had that record-setting day last week. The senior from Mobile, Alabama. Call it third and a long four at the 41-yard line. No score. Blazers and Choctaws in the first period at Cleveland Field in Valdosta on a Saturday afternoon. The rain has stopped, but it's kind of gray right now. Homecoming for many VSU alumni who are back for a big homecoming weekend. Got a motion man to the visitor's side of the field. Pitching it deep. Looking for room at the 40. Not finding it. Great tackle on the far side of the field. Great pursuit by Parsons again. His second consecutive tackle. No running room at all for Kevin Blackman on his second consecutive carry. And Mr. Parsons beat Mr. Blackman on two straight occasions.
Nice play by George Parsons, the sophomore from Tallahassee. Good job of coming up and turning Blackman in. Great play. Great play by the Blazers on the option. Had somebody for the quarterback and had two there to take the pitch man.
Going to punt it away, and the punter for the visitors is Mike Nelson. Nelson's going to punt it from his own 30. Pretty good rush by the Blazers. A high-hanging punt. Going to be taken by the Flash Flanders. It'll be a fair catch at the 18-yard line. They haven't got the clocks fixed yet. As a matter of fact, one clock is off now, and the Blazers get the football for the second time in the game. All you stations along the line, our next break will be a 60-second network break. Our next break will be a 60-second network break as we, in the confusion just before we went on the air, had some technical problems, but our next break will be a 60-second network break. Here are the Blazers with the football at their own 18-yard line. Hatch is in the gun. And a motion man to the home side of the field, Steve Greer. Going to give it up on the ground to Dominique Ross, and he's going to be tackled in the backfield back at the 15-yard line. Oh, my, it came hard that time. Had two players in there on him. One man was Cyrone McBeath, one of the linebackers. And then the other guy was one of the defensive tackles, Roderick Upshaw, draped his arms around him, and the two of them pulled the big sophomore from Jacksonville to the turf here in Cleveland Field, and he lost a yard on the play. Call it second and 11 at the 16. Hatches in the shotgun. He's going to motion Sean Bender out to the left side just a bit. Three wideouts on the left side. Dominic Ross in the backfield with him. Hatch, long snap count. Gives it to Ross again. Ross looking for room. Tries to turn the corner, but he's going to be pushed out of bounds right at the 20-yard line on the far side of the field. Good pursuit that time on the far side, following all the way over there. And finally, wrestling and pushing and hogtying and whipping him out of bounds is McBeath again. He's actually going to pick up a couple of yards on the play. Call it third and 9 right at the 19.5. Ross and Bender are going to come out of the football game. And the clocks are still not working. No score, Mississippi College and Valdosta State University. Hatch on third and long. Blazers have not got a first down on two possessions so far. Hatch has got Blake Duncan on his right. Got the beanpole, Robert Williams in motion to the visitor side of the stadium. Hatch long snap count, low snap. Looking over the middle, got some time. Now he has no time, and the ball's on the ground. Who's going to come up with it? Looks like Mississippi College. Everybody's fighting for it. Everybody's fighting for it, and who's going to come up with it? Looks like Valdosta State University. One of the O-linemen went down there and rescued the pigskin. Matt Moore came up with it, or did he?
Yeah, he did. Matt Moore did follow it, and a nice job by Moore to get it, but Boys Blazer offense struggling early on the first couple of series.
Here's Ashby standing at the rear of the end zone, going to punt it away. Going to be taken on the dead, running to the 35, to the 30, to the 25, and knocked down right at the 25-yard line. A lot of guts there. Took it on the dead run and advanced it 10 yards. Good return that time by Ben Sanford, the sophomore from Meridian. Beautiful field position for Mississippi College, and now the hombre defense of Mike Majors has his backs against its own goal line. Only 26 yards away are the Choctaws from putting some points on this board. First time this afternoon, homecoming 1993.
Mike, Ben Sanford, one of the threats for this Choctaw offense. He's a flanker, but he's second in the Gulf South Conference in punt returns. Almost 12 yards per return.
Coming off the field, being helped off the field just a bit, the Blazers' James Sermons, the linebacker, had some problems there. Brad Strom now in at quarterback. They started, as John told you in the pregame, they started Cedric Baker, but Brad Strom in there now. Strom on the year, he's had some success throwing the ball, 40 out of 73. Four intercepts, and he's had six touchdowns. Strom looking to throw, right side, man wide open at the 22, juggled it a bit to the 15, to the 10, and pushed out of bounds on the far side of the field. Marcus Johnson pushed him out of bounds, but he gained a first down on the play, and that's going to be that great back, Kevin Blackman, out of the backfield. It'll be a first down, Mississippi College. First down of the afternoon for either the Choctaws or the Blazers.
Great fake by Brad Strom there on just a little rollout to his right, but made a great fake inside to the fullback there, and then just came out and completely fooled the Blazer linebackers like Rouse, Harvey, and Edward Mitchell, and Parsons got caught up in the middle there, and Blackman slid out wide open in the right flat.
Here's Strom under the center, got two men behind him. He's going to go first man through the fullback, straight ahead, bowls over a couple of Blazers and takes it to the 3-yard line. It'll be second down and about 2 yards to go. And carrying the mail that time was Jay Bourne, the senior from Columbia, Mississippi, staring 6 points right in the face. It'll be second down and just a couple of yards to go for the first down. And they get 3 yards away from putting six on the board. And the clocks are still not operating correctly. We're still in the first quarter. And the Blazers are right now in deep, deep trouble early. The white shirts from Clinton, Mississippi, 4-1-1 on the year. Strom is the quarterback, got a motion man to the home side, and then doubles back. Going to give it to the fullback again on the right side, and the Blazers are able to knock him down at the 1 yard line. He might have gotten the first down. George Parsons is there for the Blazers, and let's see, along that defensive front, Andre Hampton is there. Did he get the first down? That is the big question there. Again, they go to Bourne, the fullback. Where they mark it is a very important question. Looks like he's going to be just a little bit short of the first down. It'll be third and inches for the first, and he's only a yard away from the goal line. No score for either team, but a yard away from the Choctaws putting one in. They beat us twice at homecoming, and they would like to do it again, but the Blazers have other ideas. Here's Strom under the center. Two backs behind him, motion man, goes one way and then doubles back. Strom's going to give it out left side, tries to get in, will not. Blazers are going to hold, but I think he got the first down.
Yeah, this one will be close here. It looked like he did. Yeah, he's going to have the first down, I think, so they'll have four cracks inside the one.
Rasmus Harvey was there to hit him. Walt Foy was there to hit him. They lined up everybody on the line. They may come out and measure, but I think John's absolutely right. It's right down on the half-yard line. I think it's going to be a first and goal at the half-yard line for Mississippi College. The Choctaws have lost only once this year, and that was to North Alabama, the number one team in the nation, 38-28. They tied Livingston 22-22. It will be a first and goal at the half-yard line. Now the clock is working correctly. 7:43 to go, and that's on both the clocks. 7:43 to go in the first quarter. No score, Blazers and Choctaws. But the guys from Clinton have some ideas. Brad Strom is under the center. Two men behind him. In the backfield, got a motion man to the home side, and he doubles back to the visitor side. Strom's going to go right side, fullback again. Touchdown! Mississippi College, as Bourne takes it in from 1 yard away with 7:22 to go in the first quarter. Nothing fancy, John. They got it down there close and just kept banging that fullback in there.
Yeah, I was surprised to see them use Brad Strom at quarterback because they started the drive at the 25 and, basically into the red zone. You'd think they'd have the running quarterback in there, but Strom gets a big completion on the first play of the drive that brings it down inside the 15, and then from there it was Jay Bourne doing most of the work.
Charlie McGinn is the kicker, and the hold is down, and McGinn gets a good snap, and the kick is up. looks like he missed it left side, but no, they say it goes through. It's 7-0 Mississippi College, 7:22 to go in the first quarter. We'll take a 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
The VSU Blazers are South Georgia's college football team. Just like Swanee Swifty is South Georgia's home team store, designed with your convenience in mind. Swanee Swifty Store serves South Georgia with over 200 locations, so when you're on your way to the big game and you need something in a hurry, drop by Swanee Swifty. The drinks and chips, a great combination, just like VSU and South Georgia.
Again to kick off. Blazers going to have Blake Duncan, Calvin Walker, and Flash Flanders back inside the 5-yard line. 7-0 Mississippi College, a shock early. Here's the kickoff. Going to be a very deep one taken in the end zone by Duncan, and he will not run it out. It'll be first and 10 at the 20 for Hal Mummy's Blazers. John, we haven't seen this team trail much this year. Last week against West Georgia and then down at the Citrus Bowl against Central Florida.
Well, I mean, I think it goes back to what you have to realize about this offense. It's kind of a hot and cold. I mean, you can come out a couple of series, do absolutely nothing, but come over the sidelines, make a couple of adjustments and you know, find some seams. So way too early to start being concerned. But, yeah, it's always nice when we put points on the board first.
Hatch is in the gun, got a man on his left and his right. Three-step drop looking, left side, got his man there. It's Pender at the 25 to the 26-yard line. Coming over and make the stop for the Choctaws is Brian Richardson, the junior from Forest, Mississippi. He'll pick up 6 on the play, call it 2nd and 4 at the 26. Clock's running at 7:05 in the first quarter, and the Blazers trail 7-0 to the Choctaws from Clinton.
I think what you'll see, Mike, is you'll see this Blazer offense start to take what's there. I think you're going to get a lot of underneath. Pass routes, a lot of 5 and 6 yard pass completions.
Hatch is in the gun again. Same offensive set, Steve Greer in motion to the visitor's side. Now they're gonna give it up on the ground to Reginald Walker, and he's tackled in the backfield. Oh, White came hard, long, and often in Cyrone McBeath. Just had his arms around Walker as soon as he touched the football.
Yeah, great play there by McBeath, and you know, he has 59 tackles on the year. He's second. As we talked about, Rich Myers, the other linebacker, has 69. Willie Turnage, the other linebacker, has 2 sacks. So they like the Blazers. They've been coming right up the bottom from the linebacker position.
Walker and Dominique Ross in the backfield now. Steve Greer's a short man in the slot on the right side. Hatch is in the gun. Got Calvin Walker on the left side. Maybe stretch him out a bit here, and does. He's got the beanpole. Robert Williams, it was in his hands, and it flipped up in the air. And a good play by the safety who came over and got just a finger on it. Keith Martin, the ball flipped up in the air. Looked like that Robert Williams may have a chance to go for it, but not the case, as now it's 4th down, and the Blazers will kick it away again.
Well, again, with the 2-deep safeties just trying to hit a seam route up the right sideline, looked like Robert Williams maybe could have stopped and come back and caught it, but didn't do it. Good play by Mississippi College.
Here's Ashby punting the Sanford on at the 42. He's trying to turn the corner, does at the 45 to the 50 across midfield to the 8-yard line. Down there. Oh, he slipped right through the black shirts that time and gained an extra 7 yards that possibly he should not have. 5:52 to go in the first quarter. The Blazers trail 7-0. And again, the Choctaws are in flame red and black territory in front of the alumni on a homecoming great Saturday afternoon at Cleveland Field.
Thank you. You look back to last week, and one of the disappointing things was the play of the defense in the second half. We didn't really stop West Georgia, so imperative to come out and make some big plays here.
They bring back in Cedric Baker at quarterback. Baker's going to give it up on the ground again. They take it across the 45 to the 43-yard line. Mitchell makes the tackle. And a man who carried the football was J.D. Hampton, the sophomore fullback from Meridian, Mississippi. Picks up 7 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 3 at the 43-yard line. And the clock's running at 5:35 in the first quarter. And the Blazers trail 7-0.
running behind a huge offensive line for Mississippi College. They, if you look at some of these guys here, left tackle 6'5", 260. Right, left guard 6'5", 268. And their right tackle 6'8", 291.
Baker at quarterback again under the center. Going to stay on the ground again. This time he gives the Blackman across the 40 to the 39-yard line. It'll be a first down. Marcus Johnson, Edward Mitchell in to make the tackle, but another first down. And as John said at the top of the show, these guys, they just want to run. They don't particularly want to throw the football. Hal Mummy said they like to run two times for every time they throw it. Well, that's exactly what they're doing so far. They come in here as the number two rushing team in the league, 243 yards a game on the ground, only 153 yards a game through the air. That's number five in the Gulf South Conference. Now, with this great field position, they're content to bang it out on the ground. Blazers rush four with three linebackers. Here's Baker under the center. Got two men behind him. Going to go to first man through, and again, it's the fullback. He's going to get maybe a yard on the play as the Blazers smell it out and stop it up pretty good. The man who made the tackle was Shea Williams for VSU, and the man who carried the football was J.D. Hampton, the sophomore fullback. Again, he'll pick up a yard. It'll be second and nine. Rasmus Harvey comes in. Ryan Branch checks out.
We talked about the Choctaws' right tackle, Brad Creel, 6'8", 291. He's a senior. He's playing with 15 stitches in his lip. I think it happened in practice last week. So he's a tough kid to be playing like that. He is a tremendous size football player, and he'll have a chance to burn and throw in any fire possibly.
Will stop the game momentarily. John, what do you think about switching these quarterbacks in and out like this? What's the philosophy there?
Well, it's some coaches don't like to do it, but Mississippi College has done it in the past, and it's worked out well for them.
Baker's in there now. He's got a motion man to the visitor's side, then he doubles back, then he goes again. Baker's going to roll right, look to throw the ball down the field, trying to get it right over the head, and almost made a great comeback route that time, Ben Sanford, but not quite. Over there on the deep, Valdosta State University, no chance to intercept the pass, but over there with a chance to play some great defense was Mike Gibson, the freshman cornerback from Bainbridge.
Yeah, nice play by Mike Gibson that time. They sent Ben Sanford out in the right flat and tried to pump it to him and then send him up the sideline. I try to catch the Blazers biting on the short route, but number 30, Mike Gibson, the freshman from Bainbridge, does a great job of running with Sanford and able to break it up.
Blazers rush four with three linebackers, all in black this afternoon. Now we sneak another man right up along the line of scrimmage. Here's Baker, fakes it. He's got him in his bag, and he's going to throw quickly to this side, and Blackman's going to catch the ball at the 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Kevin Blackman, and what a play by Cedric Baker as he smelled the blitz coming, and there with his arms wrapped around him was Andre Randall, but he still was able to get the ball to Blackman, and Blackman takes it 40 yards for a touchdown for Mississippi College, and his homecoming crowd is stunned. What a gloomy Saturday afternoon at Cleveland Field.
A tremendous play by Cedric Baker, the quarterback for the Blazers, number 40. Andre Randall blew in there on the blitz and had him wrapped up, but Baker just turned and had the strength to get the ball over to Blackman. Because of our blitz, we didn't have very much containment back on the backside, and Kevin Blackman takes it the distance.
Charlie McGinn for the extra point. The hold is down. The kick is up. It is no good. 13-0 Mississippi College, 3:55 to go in the first quarter. We'll take a 30-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
This fall, the Framing Workshop has much more in store for everyone. Hello, this is Carla Penny, and all of us invite you in soon to see the fall edition of the Framing Workshop. Come and see our wearable art, t-shirts by Monet, Van Gogh, Raphael, and others, and prints to match for your living room, dorm room, or even your office. We do great framing, too, and the new VSU diplomas look exquisite. Fall in this fall to the Framing Workshop at Barclay Square by the mall.
Mike Chase and John Lastinger just commiserating, I guess, up here in the booth on what a play that was. I mean, it was a great football play by Baker. No question about it. Andre Randall had both arms around his waist, and he turned him toward the receiver, and there he was able just to flip it right off the Blackman. And Blackman, when he gets it, he certainly knows what to do with it, and he takes it for a touchdown. 13-0 as McGinn missed the extra point. 3:55 to go in the first quarter. Here's McGinn to kick off. Blake Duncan standing at the goal line. And Calvin Walker standing way out to the visitor side of the field, and Flash Flanders on this side. They're going to kick it right to the Flash, and he's going to be, will he run out of there? No, he will not. He'll kneel down just before he crossed the goal line. Mark Beats, he made a tremendous block on one of the on-rushing kick return men for Mississippi College, and the crowd responds just a bit.
Well, we're going to need something like that. We really need a little jump start here to get this Blazer offense in gear. Mississippi College has done exactly what they've wanted to do. That's come out and ball control early, and they got a break there. Gotten started with great field position on both drives, and it's worked out well for them so far.
Hatch is in the gun. This Blazer offense needs to get it going right here, and I believe they will. And Steve Greer going to go in motion to the visitor's side. Here's Hatch. He threw Greer 12 balls last week. He's going to throw to short man Reginald Walker, 20, 25, 26-yard line. And heads out of bounds on the visitor's side of the field. And there's a man who's had his name called a lot already this afternoon, Cyron McBeat, the senior linebacker. And he twists and turns and gets the little wide receiver out of bounds, Reginald Walker. So Hatch is able to pick up a 6-yard gain. It'll be 2nd and 4 for the Hatch man, the junior from Mount DeSales High School in Macon, Georgia. Chris Hatcher, he's the son of a coach, Edgar Hatcher, who's the head coach at Southwest Macon, the Patriots also up in Macon, Georgia. 3:48 to go. Hatch fakes the run. Now he's going to look down the field. Maybe try to stretch him out. Tons of time. Got his man Calvin Walker at the 34-yard line. First down, Valdosta State University.
Great job by that offensive line there, Mike. Gore Kerensky, Matt Moore, Sean Bostic, Tim Fleming, Chuck Stamey, all giving Chris Hatcher all kinds of time to look around. Good job by Calvin Walker working free on the left side. And Chris Hatcher, as he normally does, finds him for the Blazers' first down of the ballgame.
Brian Richardson makes the stop for Mississippi College. 3:33 in the first quarter. Blazers trail 13-0. Hatches in the gun. Blake Duncan on his left. Motion man is Greer to the home side. Robert Williams wide to the right. Looking for Williams all the way. Now he throws to the short one, Greer. Greer at the 38-yard line. He's going to be knocked down as soon as he catches the football. And McBeat comes over and makes the tackle. Wanted the beanpole down the field that time, but he saw the defense coming, so he dumps it off to his short man.
Yeah, it looked like he had Robert Williams working free on the right side down on the old 15-yard out route, but elected to hit Greer. Chris Hatcher, I think if he has one weakness, he doesn't throw the ball on the run very well. He's had some problems this year, so that time, rather than throw the long pass, just took the quick short one to Greer.
Picks up 4 on the play. Call it 2nd and 6. Greer in motion. Then he doubles back to the home side. Hatch is going to throw out this side to Flash Flanders, and that's almost a lateral there as he kind of threw it behind him. And are they going to mark it there? They very well might.
Yeah, that
they
will.
That'll be a lateral. No chance Flash was going to throw that football. What do you think, John? We saw Reggie throw one last week.
I don't know. It didn't look like it. It looked like he had Steve Greer coming out to block, and it was into the short side of the field, so I don't think that that Stanley Flanders was going to throw it, but unfortunately puts the Blazers in a hole.
Here's Hatch in the gun. 13. The ball's sitting at the 31-yard line of VSU. Hatch has got Dominique Ross on his right, 3 wideouts on the left. Now they back off the line. They'll rush 4. Here's Hatch rolling left and looking to throw. Does it right in between to Calvin Walker at the 50, to the 45, at the 40, at the 35, at the 30, at the 25, and pulled out of bounds at the 20. Calvin Walker, as Hatch just threaded the needle right between 2 white shirts, and Calvin Walker, his favorite target, was right there, and he certainly made a scintillating run after he caught the football.
Nice job there. Nice job, first of all, by Chris Hatcher. Had a little bit of a pass rush coming, and he stepped up in the pocket, moved up, bided a little time there, and found Walker right between a couple of linebackers. Had the first down, and of course, Calvin Walker, as we know, has the ability to make something happen when he catches it, and he does. Big play for the Blazers. Maybe that's what we need to get a little spark in this offense.
On a 3rd and 13, Calvin Walker carries it to the 21-yard line. Hatch is in the gun. Blazers trail 13-0. Going to give it up to Reginald Walker, trying to turn the corner right side at the 15, at the 10, dives for the 6-yard line. And it should be another Blazer first down, and will be, as Reginald Walker made a nice dive for it and carries it down there and makes a great, great, great move. It'll be first down Blazers. Will it be inside the 10? It will at the 9. First and goal at the 9-yard line. Now this Blazer offense is starting to kick into high gear.
Well, that's something you Guy Morris, I think they concentrated on last week. Didn't have much production running the football last week, and they want to do that. They realize that's a very important for the passing game is to make sure this running game works as well. So nice job that time by Reginald Walker.
Hatches in the gun. Got a motion man. It's Dominic Ross, the sophomore fullback. Looking left side. Got a man, Calvin Walker, at the 10. To the 5. He hits it hard right at the 5-yard line and wiped out. McBeath is there. And also in on the stop for the visitors from Clinton, Mississippi, is Shannon Garrett, the junior D-back from Bay St. Louis, Mississippi. 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. The Blazers trail 13-0.
Boy, great play by Mississippi College there. You see, this team didn't win the national championship in 89 for us. I mean, they have a tradition of being a fierce, aggressive bunch of football players, and that's just what we saw right there. They really leveled Calvin Walker.
Hatches under the center, got Dominique Ross in his backfield. Motion man is Robert Williams to the home side. Blazers all in black this afternoon. Going to look into the end zone. Nobody's home. Nobody's home. Threw it right over the head of some on-rushing folks. Tried to get it to his tight end that time, but no chance for David Banks, who's already caught a couple of touchdowns this year, to catch up with that football.
Yeah, Chris Hatcher recognized man coverage there all the way across on the right side and just tried to work Banks free in the back of the end zone. Just tried a little quick lob, but Banks had a hard time getting off the line of scrimmage. Was held up.
It'll be third and goal at the 6-yard line for the Blazers of Hal Mummy. Hatches under the center. Got Dominic Ross and Blake Duncan in the backfield. Here's Robert Williams, the beanpole in motion to the home side. Hatch is going to look into the end zone again. He's got time. Now he has, though. Now he's going to scramble out of there. At the 5, throws the short one. Touchdown, David Banks. Oh, they thought they had Hatcher. They thought they had Hatcher wrapped up back at the 8-yard line, but he slipped from the grasp of a white shirt. Kept his composure, rolled left, and threw it to Banks right at the end of the end zone. Touchdown, Valdosta State University.
Boy, have we ever seen Chris Hatcher break a tackle? I don't think we have, and if he had the in-the-grass rule, I'm not sure that would have been a touchdown. But Hatcher pulls free and makes a little magic happen.
Here's the extra point. Vernon Laurie puts it up, and it is good. 13-7, 1:25 to go in the first. Blazers are coming back, and we'll take a 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Sir, you can't come in the studio.
It's all right. I'm Dave's cousin Ed. I'm filling in.
But the script says Dave.
It's just an oversight.
Sure?
Trust me.
Okay. Wendy's, take one.
Hi, this is Dave Thomas' cousin Ed. Let's cut through it. With Wendy's 99-cent super value menu, you can put together a feast for next to nothing. For example, you take a bowl of chili and a baked potato, Caesar side salad, and a biggie drink. At 99 cents each every day, you get a great meal for diddly. My brother-in-law, Bill, well, he lives off the super value menu. Of course, he's tighter than a rusted nut.
Excuse me, Cousin Ed, that's not in my script.
It's called ad-libbing. Dave will love it. For the kids, there's Wendy's $1.99 hamburger kids meal, including a toy. So get on down to participating Wendy's. Oh, here comes Cousin Dave. Gotta go.
Oh, hi, Dave. How you doing?
Okay, but I could swear I just saw Cousin Ed.
Enjoy one of the delicious items on Wendy's 99-cent super value menu, available at Wendy's in Valdosta.
And that's something to get this homecoming crowd fired up about. Jerry Diller to kick off. Mississippi College going to send two men back at the 8-yard line. Here's the kick. Going to be taken at the 9, to the 10, to the 15, right up the middle, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, down the sideline, 20, 15, 10, 5, back out of bounds at the 3-yard line. Oh, my. What a return that time, and saving the touchdown was Billy Poole.
Great play by Billy Poole, but Kevin Blackman, there he goes. That's a big, big play for these Choctaws. Looks like the Blazers taking a little bit of momentum back, and all of a sudden he takes a kickoff some 80-something yards right back to bring them right back down the field for the third time today. They're starting to drive with tremendous field position.
First and goal at the 9-yard line for Mississippi College. 1:12 to go in a wild first quarter. And timeout, Choctaws. We'll do the same with your score. Mississippi 13, Blazers 7. We'll take a 30-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Unless you're a travel professional, you can't always know all there is to know about airfares, seasonal rates, package tours, and other details about a successful trip. That's why you should see the travel professionals at South Georgia Travel. South Georgia Travel has served the travel needs of our area since 1964, and we're dedicated to offering the quality travel services you deserve. Call 244-2324 or stop by. It'll be our pleasure to serve you.
Vince Glover just electrified him in the wrong sort of way, as in being shocked, as he takes the kickoff after the VSU touchdown all the way down to the 9-yard line. Brad Strom back in at quarterback. Strom's going to give out right side, and again, it's Glover, and Glover's going to take it to the 8-yard line. George Parsons makes the stop there. Glover probably still hadn't got his win.
You're exactly right. I mean, it's just a tremendous return. Didn't really have a seam in there, just found one and then cut it back to the right side down in front of the Blazer bench. But I tell you what, this Blazer defense really needs to make a stop here. We got a good play there on the first down play from George Parsons. Let's see if we can keep him from getting a touchdown.
Second and goal at the 9. Blazers send the blitz, and he gets it. Edward Mitchell blitzes, and he knocks Strong down. He smelled it out, and he diagnosed it perfectly, and Mitchell comes in there and wraps his arms around Brad Strom and brings 2 yards on the play. It'll be third and goal at the 11.
Nice play by Edward Mitchell. You saw him blitzing there. You saw him coming, and the Mississippi College offensive line just couldn't make the adjustment to cut him off. And he came right between the guard and tackle untouched and there to wrap up Strom and throw him for a loss.
That will be the last play of the first quarter. After 1, your score, Mississippi College 13, Blazers 7. We'll take a 90-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
For everyday life.
Third down, goal to go for Mississippi College. And again, Cleveland Field has some clock problems as 19:59 showing on one clock and zeros on the other clock. They got the score and the down and to go and ball on and all that kind of stuff right, but it's the clock that's not working. Now they're going to go back to the hand clock as they did at the start of the football game. Ball's at the 11-yard line. Strom is still the quarterback. He's going to look into the end zone. Now he's being chased out of there. Now he's going to roll right. Got some pasture in front of him. Headed for the end zone. He's going to be at the 1. He's going to be at the 1. And that will be... Erasmus Harvey was there. Shea Williams was there. Tony Hill was there, but he did not get into the end zone, and that's the most important thing. But now it's 4th and goal at the 1. Do you kick the 3, John, or you go ahead and try to stick it home?
Well, they're going for it. The way they moved the football here in the first half, they're going to go for it, which I think I may have to go for a field goal here, because if by chance the Blazers stop them here, we may have a big momentum swing. But if you're a Blazer fan, pound the floor.
Here we go, Blazers. Got to stop him right here. Got a motion man to the opposite side. Blackman's going to fake the run. Now he wants to throw it right side. Touchdown! And a flag. Threw it to Blackman for the touchdown. And the Blazers were right there with him, but he kept his concentration longer than Mike Gibson. Gibson fell down, and Blackman caught the touchdown pass and a flag down. The only way that could help BSU if it's an offensive interference. And I don't think it is. They're going to come over and decipher and unscramble. And they're talking to the Mississippi College side of the football.
Yeah, I think it'll have to be a holding penalty on like David Gibson there, tried to hold Blackman. But good play by Strom there. I think he wanted to run the option, but Blazers, David Gibson had come up and had good containment. But I think the way the play works there is just that if the option's not there, Blackman's just going to continue it out into the end zone, and Strom has the option of lobbing a pass, and that's just what he did.
And it will be a penalty against Gibson on the interference. Of course, declined. The touchdown stands. And it's 19-7, Mississippi College over the flame, red and black on a gray Saturday afternoon. Homecoming, 1993. Now they'll line up for the two-point conversion. And Strom is still in there at quarterback. He and Cedric Baker have alternated at the signal caller's position. Going to line up for two as earlier McGinn missed the extra point under the center. Going to fake it. Now the end around. Strom still got the football. He's going to roll right, try to throw it short. Got his man, Blackman again. He's Mr. Do-Everything for the Choctaws, and he just got a two-point conversion. 21-7, Mississippi College over Valdosta State University. We'll take a 30-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
This is Bart Bosch. Oftentimes, people get the notion that the only way to get the best deal on a new vehicle is to drive hundreds of miles out of town. Now, at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, we make this pledge to our customers. We will meet or beat any competitor's price for a new Oldsmobile, Buick, GMC truck, or new Isuzu. Now you can be assured without trips to Jacksonville, Tallahassee, or wherever, you'll get the best deal at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu on any model, any day, any time. Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu.
You don't want to have to put pressure on yourself to have to score points. It's can sometimes force you out of your game plan. So Mississippi College has really come out and played well early in the ball game. And I think if somebody had told them they would have 21 here early in the second quarter, they'd be happy to take it.
Last year, VSU beat these same guys 28-14. But Mississippi College beat VSU in the first college football game ever played by Valdosta State, 28-13, back in 1982 out in Clinton, Mississippi. Here's the kickoff. He's going to kick it. He's going to kick it through the goalpost at the other end, but he had a penalty there that really helped him. Kicked it right through the middle of the goalpost at the other end, but he had a penalty, and that was the penalty called against Mike Gibson down on the touchdown play. John, I was about to be amazed by that one.
Well, you know, that was an interference call. Mississippi College declines the penalty, right? I mean, they decline the penalty, take the touchdown. Where's the penalty? Why are we penalized on the kickoff? I guess if it occurs in the end zone, maybe.
I guess so. I guess that would be the call. BSU, first and 10 at the 20. Hatch is going to be in the gun, looking out. Got his man over here at the 25-yard line as Sean Pender catches the pass, and immediately McBeath comes over there and makes sure he stays down, although he didn't have to once his knee touched. It'll be a 5-yard gain, second and 5 at the 25. Blazers got to move it again, and as John said earlier, the best way to respond to a touchdown is go ahead and stick one of your own in the end zone at the other end of the field. Blazers are at the right end of your radio dial, moving to the left end, all in black. Field is green, but the Blazers have the black shirts, the black pants, the black hats with the flame red on the side. Hatch is in the gun. Got a man on his right and on his left. Deep drop, looking over the middle. Got a man there. It's Greer at the 42. One-handed grab by Steve Greer on the near side hash mark. And Greer made the catch of the game right there. Caught 12 balls last week, and he really comes to play every single Saturday.
What great play. Great catch here. We see him working through the middle of the field like he always does, but that time, Chris, like he had overthrown it there, and Greer just stuck one hand out, his right hand, and pulled that thing in and then took a tremendous lick.
First and 10, Blazers at the 43-yard line, so that's going to be an 18-yard pass play from Chris Hatcher to Steve Greer. White shirts rush four with three linebackers. Hatch is in the gun. Duncan on his left, Dominique Ross on his right. Greer goes in motion to the visitor side. Going to give it up to Ross. Ross is going to try to cut it back to the right side. Ross at midfield. Ross at the 45. Ross at the 43. Ross at the 40 and out of bounds. On the far side as Dominique Ross made a great decision to cut it back across the field and finally grabbing his shoulder pads and slinging him out of bounds is Patrick Lloyd, the junior linebacker from Morton, Mississippi. First down, VSU.
Well, it was great to see Dominic Ross coming back and having a big play, but I think you could see right there as he broke it out around the right side. He really didn't have that fourth gear that we've seen because of that that injured foot there with the turf toe. So, but a nice play. Good to see that running game starting to click here.
Hatch is in the gun. Deep drop, looking over the middle. Now he's got time. Right side, got his man there, but he couldn't quite get there. Reginald Walker was held up right in front of the Mississippi College bench by the safety over there on that side, Tony Holmes, and prevented him from getting to that pass. Hatch actually threw it to the spot where he was supposed to be, John.
Yeah, it was a good throw by Chris Hatcher. Again, taking advantage of a two-deep secondary. You got two safeties back on the hash mark, and you got cornerbacks up underneath playing a tight coverage, and you can find a seam back in there, and that's right where Chris Hatcher was trying to throw it.
Hatch is in the gun again. Don't know how much time left, but we're in the second quarter. The clock is not working. 21-7 MC over VSU. Hatch this side. Short man is Bender at the 36-yard line. You're going to pick up four on the play. It'll be second and, check that, it'll be third and six at the 36. John's looking over the first quarter stats. What do you got?
A couple of stats for you, Mike. Chris Hatcher, 9 of 12, 83 yards and a touchdown. I think one of the stats that sticks out here, we had a minus 11 total yards of rushing in the first quarter. We're going to have to do a little better than that. For Mississippi College, let's see, they have nothing of real of interest. Brad Strom, 1 of 2 for 37 yards.
Hatch is in the shotgun. He's got Greer in motion to the visitor's side of the field. Hatch is going to take the snap, fake the run to Ross, roll right, look to throw down the field on the naked bootleg. Got a man there, and he had his head taken off, but Calvin Walker caught the football. Had his head taken off. I mean, that was some kind of defensive play there by Mississippi College's Tony Holmes, but Calvin Walker caught on the foot, caught and held on to the football miraculously, and it's going to be a first down. Blazers on the far hash mark right at the 22-yard line, and the Blazers are marching goalward once again.
Yeah, great play there. Great catch by a good concentration by Calvin Walker coming from the backside across the field, and Chris Hatcher goes to him. And looked like a great defensive play, as you said, but Walker, give him credit, he made a great catch.
Calvin Walker wide to the left side this time. Reggie Walker goes in motion to the visitor's side. Deep drop by Hatch. Wants to go in the end zone, throws to his short man and stand. It's beanpole at the 10, 5, 3, 2. And he's knocked down in a flag, a late flag. Robert Williams is going to get a Blazer first down at the 2-yard line. Coming down to make the stop is Richard Myers. And what's the flag all about?
Clipping on the Blazers.
It'll be from the point of infraction, so it could, well, it won't be a first down, but
I'm not sure. This clipping could have been a low block. I'm not, but let's see. Yeah, I think they got Reginald Walker is right where the flag went, and it happened on a 5-yard line, so let's see how far they'll move it back.
McBeath is out there talking to him, and there's 5, there's 10, and there's 15, and it's going to be back to the 21-yard line.
How many times have we seen a penalty just really come at a bad time? It just, it gets old. It really does.
An inopportune moment, although there's never an opportune moment for a penalty. So the Blazers are going to have the football. First, and it wipes out, it virtually just wipes out the entire play is what it does. It's going to be first and 9 at the 21-yard line. Hatch is in the gun. It got Blake Duncan on his right. He's got the two Bobsey twins on the left, Calvin Walker and Flash Flanders. Hatch wiping his hands on a little towel here. The only, now looking left side. Now he's got to throw it. Now he's got to get out of there. Now he's got quick feet, and he's going to give it up to Greer at the 15 to the 10-yard line. Steve Greer, first down Blazers. Greer knew where that first down marker was and got to it before Richard Myers brought him down. It'll be a first down, VSU. 10-yard pass play, Hatch to Greer.
Good play. What we're seeing from Chris Hatcher is something we haven't really seen, and he's moving around a little bit in the pocket. And he's doing it in the way that he's giving himself some more time to look around. That time stepped up, moved over to his right, and found Greer right there in front of him.
Blazers trail 21-7 in the second quarter. Hatch wants to get it a little closer here. Got Flash Flanders in motion to the visitor's side. Hatch is going to roll right and look to throw the football. Short man is Dominique Ross at the 10. He's going to be three men jump on him at the 7-yard line. First man to get a hand on him was Tony Holmes, that same D-back. So it'll bring up a second down. He did not want to go to Ross, but that was his outlet man on the play, and he's able to pick up a couple of yards. They're going to mark it right at the 6.5. 21-7 MC over VSU. Duncan's going to come out. Reggie Walker's going to come in. It was about this spot in the field where Reggie Walker scored the first touchdown ever for Valdosta State University against Mount Scenario. Let's see if they try to repeat that same play. Ball's on the far side hash mark. Hatch is under the center. The motion man is Flanders. Flanders circles back to the home side of the field. Hatch is going to throw it, looking into the end zone. Over the middle, got his man. Touchdown, Valdosta State University. Went out of the hands of the D-back, into the hands of Flash Flanders. Almost an interception by Richard Myers, but it went right out of his hands into Stanley Flanders' hands, and VSU is on the board, and the Flag has caught his 8th touchdown pass of the season, and a flag down in the end zone, probably against Mississippi College for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Yeah, like number 14, Rich Myers, the linebacker for the Choctaw, slamming his helmet down. I think he was upset there. I'm not sure what it is, but it's after the play, and so the Blazers should come a touchdown. Let's talk about the touchdown. Blazers got a break, Mike, because that pass very well could have been intercepted, but it was tipped up, and Stanley Flanders with the great concentration to make the catch. It's a big play for the Blazers, and it gets them right back in the ball game.
What it is offsetting penalties, a holding call against MC and an unsportsmanlike conduct against VSU, and somebody jumped on the extra point, and it was blocked. It was blocked. And Laurie went down out of the Mark Beach hole, and we got flags all over the place.
We got number 22, Blake Duncan, for the Blazers. He's down, too. I think he's hurt.
I think he is, too. He's putting one hand to the right hand to the ground, and now Edward Mitchell is now he's going to try to limp off the field, and the trainers come over and get with him immediately. Blake Duncan is coming off the field under his own power.
That's not good at all. He doesn't look to be like we're going to see him anytime soon. I don't know if it's a knee or an ankle, but Coach Jim Madalino quickly attending to him.
MC jumped, and the penalty is against the Choctaws. So Laurie puts it up and through, and he kicks it right out into the trees in the yard on the other side. And the Blazers have narrowed the gap to 21-14 in the second period, and we'll take a 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
VSU Blazers are South Georgia's college football team. Just like Swanee Swifty is South Georgia's home team store, designed with your convenience in mind. Swanee Swifty store serves South Georgia with over 200 locations, so when you're on your way to the big game and you need something in a hurry, drop by Swanee Swifty. There's always one nearby. And don't forget Swanee Swifty Trinks and Chips, a great combination just like VSU and South Georgia.
Valdosta State University to kick off, trailing 21-14 at homecoming. We don't know how much time left in the second quarter, probably about midway through or so. And Jerry Dillard's going to do the honors. Going to have the ever dangerous, and I mean the last time he proved how dangerous he was, Vince Glover back there to receive the kickoff. Glover's going to take it again at the 9, to the 10, to the 15, to the 20. Comes to this side. 21, 22, 24-yard line, and this time the Blazers make sure that he doesn't do anything beyond that. Billy Poole is over there on the stop of former Lowndes High School product. So Glover doesn't do the heroics he did last time for the Choctaws, and now maybe this Blazer defense of Mike Majors can really bite its lower lip and bend its back and come down and stop these Choctaws from Mississippi.
Well, it's the first time that Mississippi College has had to start field position backed up a little bit.
Good point.
So maybe this Blazer defense can take advantage of that. Mike Quickly, third quarter score. Kentucky leads Georgia 28-27.
Boom, got a tight one. Frederick Baker's back in at quarterback. Two backfield mates behind him, receivers left and right. Blazers rush four. Pitches it deep to Blackman. Blackman tries to get to the 25, to the 30, to the 35, 40, 45, 50, 45, and out of bounds on the far side of the field. A big throw happens indeed as Edward Mitchell comes over there and runs Blackman out of bounds, but he picked up tremendous yardage on the play, a 35-yard gain by the ever-talented Kevin Blackman. It'll be a first down, Mississippi College. Like two fighters just back and forth, and one knocks the other one down, and then the one gets back up, and then he gets knocked down again. Back and forth they go. Whoever has the ball last in this one. 44 yards away from Glory Land. First and 10 for the Clinton, Mississippi visitors on a Saturday afternoon at Cleveland Field.
So much for the good field position, backing them up a little bit.
Here's Baker, two men behind him. He's going to go first man through. His fullback got hit hard by Parsons, and then he leapt forward and got maybe another yard on the play. Andre Randall is there on the stop, along with Marcus Johnson and other Blazers. Here's Andre Hampton getting up as well. And the fullback carried the football that time. Jay Bourne, the senior from Columbia, Mississippi, picks up a yard. It'll be second and nine at the 42-yard line. The sky got a little bright just a minute ago. Now it's graying again and a little bit of a mist in the air.
Looks like Blake Duncan's up and jogging on the sideline, so I think he doesn't appear that it's a serious injury, so that's good for the Blazers.
Second and nine, Hal Mummy down talking to Chris Hatcher just down below. Mummy in a sport coat this afternoon. Baker's going to roll right and look to throw the ball down the field. Over the middle, got his man there, and he's not able to hang on to the 28-yard line. Took a tremendous blow from Andre Randall and Marcus Johnson and Tony Hill as he tried to catch the football. Good throw by Baker, though. He put it right into his chest. And I think it was the black shirts defending that really caused that pass to be incomplete because the throw was right in Ben Sanford's chest.
Yeah, it was a good throw there by Cedric Baker, and he's not known. He comes into the game 26 of 54 for 351 yards. That's only 48% completion percentage, but he made a nice throw there.
21-14, Blazers down seven. We're in the second quarter. Motion man to the visitor's side. Here's Baker. Baker looking to throw again on the quarterback draw right at the middle. 40, 35, and by George Parsons at the 35. He's a yard short of the first down. Just a yard short of the first down, it will be. Should be a fourth down and about, about a yard. Right at a yard to go. Got to get to the 34. They're going to spot it right at the 35. Just inches away from the 35-yard line. 21-14.
No question about it. The Choctaws will go for it here, fourth and one. I think their philosophy, we talked about it. They want to hang on to the football, and this is a chance to do it.
They got Baker in there, quarterback. He's under the center. Got that big fullback Bourne behind him. He's going to pitch it deep, however, looking at it, and he picks it too deep, and the Blazers are going to stop it. Blazers are going to stop it. No chance. Erasmus, Harvey, Edward Mitchell, George Parsons, Andre Hinton, Walt Foy. No route for the ball carrier to go on that particular play, and they knock Glover down back there, and the Blazers are going to take over the football. First and 10 at the 40-yard line, the stop of the day by the Ombre defense of Mike Blazers.
That's a big play we were looking for. Great play by George Parsons there. Pursuing up the field, forcing Kevin Blackman in. Great play by the sophomore from Leon High School in Tallahassee, Florida.
Here's Chris Hatcher. He's in the gun, standing at his own 35-yard line. His team trails 21-14. He wants to tie it up. He's going for it. Oh, the flash Denver, and he catches it, and he dropped it. And he dropped it at the 22-yard line, and flash juggled it a bit right at the 25, and he juggled it for 5 yards, and I thought he was going to haul it in, but not quite.
Yeah, unusual. Running right straight down the middle of the field in between the safeties. The throw was there. Flanders looked like he tried to catch it in a strange way. It didn't like he was going to just, you see a lot of them cradle it dead on the run there, but that time tried to reverse his hands and catch it and just couldn't hang on to it.
It'll be second and 10 at the 40-yard line. Hatch is in the gun again. No pressure, tremendous time. Over the middle, got his man Steve Graham. First down, Blazers in the Choctaw territory at the 45-yard line. Steve Greer, Mr. Dependable.
Boy, just, it's so funny to watch him. He catches it, he just sets the ball down and walks back to the huddle and kind of like, hey, I expected to do that. And That's kind of far.
Blake Duncan is onto the field now. He's off again, so he is okay. Coming Saturday afternoon. Hatch is under the center. Dominique Ross is his lone setback. Two wideouts right side. Going to give it Dominique Ross right up the gut. He's going to take it to the 42-yard line, but he's going to be knocked down there. Man who got a hand on him and pulled him down was Roland Spann, the senior nose guard from Brandon, Mississippi. It'll be second down. Picked up three. Second and a long seven from the 42. Don't know how much time's left in the quarter. Got to be getting down 3 or 4 minutes, maybe. Blazers trail 21-14. The clock malfunctioned at the start of the football game and then again in the second period. Worked for a while. Hatch is going to bring Williams on to the right side. He lined up on the left side. He's got... Pender to the 40, to the 35, to the 34-yard line on a short pass play. Another first down for VSU. In there to make the stop for the visitors from Clinton is Roland Spann. Again, the nose guard from Brandon. But it'll be a first down Blaze. A chance to take this one in and tie it up before intermission. We wish we knew how much time was left, but we don't.
Nice play there. That play is almost there like a running play. A little quick screen, just Chris Hatcher raising up and just flips it right straight to Sean Pender, line up on the left side. It almost like a running play.
Hatch is in the gun. Got Duncan on the right side. He catches the ball at the 35, to the 30, to the 28-yard line, and pulled down by a bunch of white shirts right there at the 28-yard line. Picks up seven on the play. It'll be second and three at the MC. McBeath, the linebacker over there to stop him, along with one of his mates, Willie Turnage, another linebacker, the junior from Gulfport, Mississippi. Nice play. Knees, hands, whatever was hurting a while ago are okay.
Yeah, it is, because we certainly need him. But a good play there. We're keeping the pressure on those Choctaw linebackers. They're playing the run and having to defend the pass, and that time we get out and cover.
Looking down the field into the end zone, flashes there! Touchdown!
Oh boy, that's what we like to see right there. I tell you what, that's big time. And just fired a strike to Stanley Flanders, who ran a post corner route, beat his man, and just didn't beat him by much, but a great catch by Flanders. Great concentration.
Here's Lil Reed for the extra point. Hold is down.
We're in the store once again here at Nigel's Diamonds and Gold. And fellas, it's Christmas.
That's right, Bob. We're geared up for it.
We got a lot of merchandise.
And right now, we have... Sapphire and emerald bracelet for $199. And that means at Nigel's, you can put anything on layaway and layaway now.
Nigel's Diamonds and Gold, Valdosta and Lake Park.
We'll take a 10-second break and let our stations along the line identify themselves. This is the Blazers, Brooks Edwards.
Star 105 is WSTI-FM, Quitman, Valdosta, Lake Park, and Orb Communication Station.
Valdosta State University trailing 21-7, comes back in the second quarter, and it's all knotted up at 21. Now this Ombre defense, let's see if they can stop Cedric Baker and Kevin Blackman and Brad Strom and all the other talented players from Clinton, Mississippi.
Well, they talked about wanting to hold on to the ball, and you see the Blazers make a fourth down stop on defense. The offense comes right back and scores.
Dillard kicks off. Is Glover going to get it? He is at the 5. Right up the middle of the field, 10, 15, leaps over one player, 20, knocked down at the 21. Again, good pursuit by VSU, and we got some pushes. And now the flags are going to go down and back in. The crowd rises to its feet a bit to see what that's all about. It's about an 11-yard return, and then the pushing and shoving started. Let's see.
Well, let's hope that it's offsetting, because I'm not sure, but there was a lot of pushing going on here. Let's see, they got one. Well, what do you think? They're going to give it against the Blazers. That doesn't surprise me a bit, considering the amount of penalties we have. But Mississippi College actually started the shoving there. Unfortunately, they caught number 44 for the Blazers, Raymond Baylor, retaliating, and that's always what happens. The official usually doesn't see the first lick, but he always sees the second. And that's unfortunate, because once again, the Choctaws get field position, and we haven't stopped them very well, although we did the last series. We haven't stopped them very well prior to that.
Al Mummy with arms outstretched and palms up to the South Georgia sky as if to say, what now? Brad Strom is the quarterback, first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Going to go to Blackman up the middle, and check that. It's going to be the fullback to the 49-yard line. Katie Hampton, the sophomore from Meridian, he's going to get an MC first down. And, John, it looked like the Blazer defense was still kind of stunned from the penalty and the pushing and the shoving and that sort of thing. They weren't really ready for that play.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're exactly right. They still seemed to be kind of looking around like they were complaining to the officials. You know, why did that go against us? And this Choctaw offense and coming right back at you. And again, offensive line, that fullback quick hitter is a good play for him.
Here's Strom under the center. 21-21. Strom's going to keep it himself. Broken play, right side. Can he turn the corner? He can at the 50. Sneaks inside the 50 to the 48-yard line. Over there on the stop for VSU is Mike Gibson, the cornerback, but Strom did all of that on his own. He wanted everything to go left, and all of a sudden, the door was closed, so he went back right, and he was just high-stepping his way, trying to get across midfield, and did, and actually picked up 4 yards on the play. It'll be second and 6 at the block.
Yeah, we don't expect that play from Strom. You expect Cedric Baker to make that play, but Strom on a busted play there just broke a couple of tackles and worked his way back on the right side and picked up 4 yards.
Up almost every series this afternoon. Head coach Terry McMillan, his third year at MC. He's won 15, lost 10, and tied 3. Want to pitch it deep, then he throws it out quickly left side at the 45. He's going to take it to the 43-yard line. Sanford is the man who caught the ball. He's going to be, I think, a yard short. Faked the run out of the backfield and then whirled quickly and threw out to the left side and caught Sanford. Seven on the play. Still going to be a yard short. And the Blazers are going to send in Big John Henson to bolster that defensive front on a running situation. Andre Randall's going to come out of there. It'll be third and very short, about a half a foot there. 21 all. Don't know how much time's left. We're in the second period. Mike Jason and John Lastinger along for you. Enjoying the great game of football. NCAA Division II style. Strom is under the center. Going to go straight ahead to his fullback. He's going to get hit hard. He didn't get there. He didn't get there. The Blazers really came hard and pushed him away. Erasmus Harvey was there. Edward Mitchell was there, and he did not make it. It'll be fourth down, and they're going to have to put it away, John.
Yeah, nice job. Nice play there. Good call by Mike Major, the defensive coordinator there. He got enough, kind of stacked the line of scrimmage there and was able to, when you get enough bodies there, the Blazers can use that quickness and penetrate by the...
Here's the snap and the punt. Up and away, very high. Going to let it go over his head and going to be caught by MC down at the 4-yard line. The MC player who actually caught the football was Richard Myers. And it's going to be marked right at the 5. So the Blazers 95 yards away right here, tied at 21. And we don't know how much time's left in the second quarter.
Looking down, George Parsons coming off the field. Kind of banged up there. Looks like he may have a shoulder injury or something, so we'll have to keep watching there.
Blazers are going to bring him up. Hatch is going to be almost stand. Well, Dominic Ross is lining up in the end zone. Hatch is going to be under the center, 95 yards away from taking a lead in this football game. Hatch wearing the long sleeves in the black this afternoon. White numerals trimmed in red. Got Robert Williams in motion. Going to give it to Dominic Ross at the 5, to the 10. Spins to the 13-yard line, maybe the 14. Finally in there to knock him down. 1-7 knocks another 7 down. Brian Richardson, the junior from Forest, Mississippi, and Dominic Ross, the sophomore from Jacksonville, is able to pick up 9 yards on the play. And that's the way to get out of a hole, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, nice running. What I like there is Dominic Ross taking off the left tackle there. But as you saw him about to be hit. He covered that football up with both arms.
Going to be just a yard and a half shy of the first down. Hatches under the center, same offensive set. Dominique Ross, lone setback. He's got Robert Williams out wide to the left side. Going to give it to Dominique again. Hits it off the right tackle, and he's able to get a yard, maybe two, maybe three. It'll be a first down. Blazers at the 18-yard line. Checking into the Blazer offensive unit is Ernest Marshall, a tight end, a junior from College Park, Georgia, and I don't recall mentioning his name prior to this afternoon's football contest.
Well, you're right, and he hasn't played much, but as you remember, David Banks missed last week with a bad ankle, and he's coming up limping a little bit there, so they're going to get Marshall in and get him some experience.
Banks has already caught a touchdown pass, but as John said, had his ankle all wrapped up in tape. Hatch is under the center. Dominique Ross behind him. Now he moves up two steps. Hatch is going to throw quickly this side to Calvin Walker. Walker's at the 20. Can he turn the corner? He cannot. It's heads up tackling that time by the aforementioned Brian Richardson, as Walker had nowhere to go after he caught the football.
Mike, we might mention that Chris Hatcher, with his three touchdown passes thus far in the first half, now has 29 on a year. So, he's increasing that Gulf South Conference record every time he throws one.
Breaks a record every time he steps onto the field. For VSU, it'll be a second and 10. The ball's at the 19-and-a-half-yard line. We're tied at 21 with MC. Mississippi College, the chuck toss from Clinton on a Saturday afternoon. Hatch is going to be under the center. Dominique Ross is going to be the lone setback behind him. Robert Williams split out wide to the right side. Calvin Walker is on the left side. Flash Flanders has already caught two touchdown passes this afternoon. Banks has caught one. Hatch is looking right. Got his man Beanpole. Robert Williams at the 20. Can he dance? He can dance to the 25, to the 26, 27-yard line. Robert Williams is going to be 2 yards short of the first down. It looked like they had him right at the line of scrimmage, but he was able to maintain his balance and stay on his feet. Coming over to make the stop for MC is Keith Martin, the senior D-back from McMinnville, Tennessee.
The wide receiver, middle screen. Robert Williams lines up on the right side and comes back into the middle of the field. Chris Hatcher flips the ball to him, and he gets behind the blockers there, but that time cut it all the way back across the field and picked up 8 yards.
Hatch is under the center. Dominique Ross and Blake Duncan in the backfield. Going to give it to Ross. Ross across the 30 to the 32 to the 33-yard line. First down, Blazers, and a flag down. And a flag down, and we'll try to decipher that one for you, is getting up very slowly from that line is Jimmy King, playing that tight end spot, the junior from Buford, leading the play for Dominique. It's going to be a face mask against the Choctaws.
Well, what do you know? We got a penalty on them. No, I don't mean to say
one of the few times it has happened on this homecoming afternoon. It'll be inadvertent, so it'll be 5 yards. Blazers had a first down anyway. I wish they would have known so much time was left.
He just said that, and I didn't pick that up. Something in 45 seconds, but I don't know. Blazers don't appear to be in a two-minute offense, so obviously there must be enough time.
21-21 in the second quarter. Blazers trailed 21-7 early. Here's Hatch in the gun. Three-step drop, looking down the field. Got his man Steve Greer, and he caught the ball at the 35, 30, 25, 24. Greer and the D-back arrived at the same time, and Greer took a lick but kept on ticking all the way down to the 24-yard line. His Hatch a little touch pass right over the middle, and Greer hauled it in, but you could see a collision coming, and Greer bounced out of that collision and took it for a Blazer first down at the 24-yard line.
Tremendous catch. Tremendous concentration by Steve Greer right down the middle of the field. Boy, big play for the Blazers. You know, the Choctaws come in, only had four interceptions, and it looked like they were going to get one there, but no, sir.
Hatch, three-step drop. Looking right side. Got Dominique Ross at the 20. He'll take it to the 15, to the 14-yard line. Another first down for VSU. And the man who made the stop was Richard Myers. Now this offense is cooking.
Exactly right. I'm just going to say that. Starting to see the old Blazer machine starting to roll. Yeah, that's they're doing it a little bit on the run, and they're doing it on the pass.
They'll take a timeout to set things up for this touchdown drive. 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Prepare yourself for an extraordinary new rotisserie chicken, deeply marinated with herbs and spices, then slowly roasted till golden brown. Is it from KFC? Indeed. The legendary long-lost recipe only at KFC. Taste it and believe. The new Colonel's Rotisserie Gold. At KFC, we do chicken right.
Available only at participating KFC restaurants.
Won't you make it better? Make it right. Don't settle for less. Make it last all night. Make it a Bud Light. Make it Bud Light. Never fills you up, never lets you down. Make it a Bud Light. Make it Bud Light. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Here's Hatch in the gun. He's got John Bender on his left and Dominique Ross on his right. Motion man is Steve Greer to the home side. Blazers all in black on this homecoming afternoon. Fakes the run, now looking into the end zone, throws it short. It's going to be incomplete to Bender at the 12-yard line. White shirts played that one pretty well.
Yeah, look, we had a bust on the offensive line there for Mississippi College. Number 98, Roderick Upshaw, penetrated there. It came right into Chris Hatcher's face, and he basically just throwing that ball away to Sean Pender. As what we know now, I just went over and stepped over during the break, talked to the Blazer coaches. They think there's about a minute left in the first half. As we told you, the clock is out, so we don't exactly know. But, of course, the incompletion there will stop the clock.
Tied at 21. Blazers hoping to untie it right here. It'll be second down, 10 yards to go. The football resting at the 13-yard line, 13 yards away from Bader, Glory Land, touchdown country. Low snap. Hatch looking left side, has to hurry his throw, catches the ball. Calvin Walker at the 5-yard line. It'll be a yard short of the first down. So the Blazers will have third and one at the 5, and the clock will continue to run over how much time is left. And now let's see if MC, and they do, call timeout.
45 seconds remaining in the first half.
Timeout on the field will do the same. Tied at 21, Blazers poised for Glory Land. We'll take a 30-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Hello, this is Carla Penny for the Framing Workshop. Do you have I'll get around to it framing? Most of us do. You know, those photographs, drawings by the kids, needlework you've been meaning to frame. This fall, why not bring them into the Framing Workshop and let us get to work on them? At the Framing Workshop, we specialize in framing all those I'll get around to it projects, and we do them up exquisitely. While you're in, see our great art-related gifts, but be sure to visit us soon at the Framing Workshop at Barclay Square.
Blazers going to send some tight ends into the football game on this short yardage situation. Jimmy King's in there. David Banks is in there. Dominique Ross is the lone setback. Hatch is under the center on third and one. Blake Duncan on the right side. Going to give to Ross across the 5 to the 3. Dominique first Ross. Down, VSU. First and goal for the Blazers. Got to keep an eye on that clock. If we knew how much time was left, we would certainly tell you, but they will stop the clock. McBeath made the tackle for MC.
Well, it was 45 seconds prior to that play there. They've stopped the clock. Well, they're going to measure. I thought for sure he had the first down, but it looks like they're going to, well, let's see.
Looked like there wouldn't be any question about it. He had great forward motion that time. Hatch is going to come over and talk with Hal Mummy.
Yeah, it is first down, so apparently the Blazers called a timeout.
John, to get this one in and take a 28-7 lead. That's being down 21-7 and then coming back and leading 28-21. What a comeback. But as you said, this offense is capable of doing that every single night. Down on the field, they're going to, Hal Mummy is out on the field. Now he's going to motion Hatcher back over there and also Calvin Walker back over there.
Well, I think the question was, it looked to me like Chris Hatcher looked back at Hal Mummy and held up his hands, you know, do you, signaling a timeout to Hal Mummy. And I think he was saying, hey, coach, do you want me to take a timeout? And I think Hal Mummy said, no, I don't want you to. But unfortunately, I think the officials saw Chris Hatcher do that and went ahead and called timeout. So I think actually they wanted to try to get a playoff there and then call time, or at least save the timeout for the field goal, because I think that was their third timeout.
The Blazers will take the timeout, and then Hal Mummy's making the signal out to Hatcher, and he's going to put his hat back on and get under the center and try to get six more right here with just seconds to go in the first half. Tied at 21 against Mississippi College on a homecoming afternoon. Hatch is in the gun. Got Dominique Ross on his right, Sean Bender on his left. Calvin Walker split wide to the left. Now he moves Bender into the slot on the left side. Hatch looking left all the way. Got his man there. Touchdown!
catches the 2-yard touchdown pass, and the Blazers are on the board. Here's Lurie to come on and try to do something with the PAT and give the Blazers a 7-point advantage. Got to be under 30 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Well, I hope we don't have to kick back off too.
That's true. And give Glover a chance to touch the football again. Here's Lurie for the extra point. Looked like they jumped. It's up and it is good. Blazers 28, Mississippi College 21. And that's a good feeling right there. That's a great feeling right there to come back from a 21-7 deficit. And you see Edward Mitchell coming off trying to get this crowd on its feet, and he does accomplish that as his homecoming crowd, the alumni, like to see this, and they like to see an exciting high-scoring football game, and that's exactly what it has been.
Four touchdown passes for Chris Hatcher. That's 30 on the year. Boy, when will it end? Let's hope not for a while.
For sure. It was interesting to see last week Heath Shuler, the great quarterback for Tennessee, broke the all-time Tennessee record with 18 touchdown passes in a season. I thought it would be a lot higher.
Well, you know, that kind of tells you a little bit. I mean, here's Heath Shuler, and obviously he's Division I, playing in a great conference, but 18 touchdown passes, and they're mentioning Heath Shuler for the Heisman Trophy. So I think, you know, Chris Hatcher's here with 30 touchdown passes and only 4 interceptions, and I think you got to start talking Harlan Hill Trophy for him, and he certainly needs to be considered for that thing.
There's no question. He is quite a fine player and just a junior. Let's look down and see, and I believe for Beach, it's going to be his first touchdown catch of the year, and it will be. Mark Beach catches his first TD of the – check that, Sean Pender, not Mark Beach. Sean Pender catches his – let me check those records.
Yeah, I had written Pender down, so I –
Yeah, it is Pender.
Okay.
It's Pender. Let's see if he caught one. That's his second one. He caught one other prior to that one. Second touchdown catch of the year for Sean Pender, and the Blazers lead 28-21. Here's Dillard with the kickoff. Glover is back there at the 10-yard line, just waiting and waiting. He's already had an 80-yard return this afternoon. Let's hope he doesn't duplicate that feat here. Maybe we won't even kick it to him, and we don't. It'll be low line drive on the ground, taking it to 30, to the 32, to the 33. We tried to knock his legs out from under him, and still on his feet, far side of the field, ran all the way across the field, knocked down at the 34. The man who returned the football was Mario Hansbrough, the tight end, the junior from Winona, Mississippi. It'll be Choctaw football, just seconds remaining in the first half. John Lastinger at halftime. He'll tell you about homecoming, and he'll update you the stats around the Gulf South Conference. Blazers have come from a 21-7 hole to a 28-21 lead.
We may have the largest homecoming court ever assembled in collegiate ranks. I will preview that much.
Homecoming, 1993. It's Glover back in at quarterback. Got a split backfield behind him. He's going to stay on the ground to his tailback, and that's going to be Glover. Glover's going to take it to the 44-yard line, close to a MC first down. And they're going to take a timeout, and we'll do the same. While they talk about it, we'll let you hear from our fine sponsors. We'll take a 60-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Unless you're a travel professional, you can't always know all there is to know about airfares, seasonal rates, package tours, and other details behind a successful trip. That's why you should see the travel professionals at South Georgia Travel. South Georgia Travel has served the travel needs of our area since 1964.
And we're back today from the Travel Services Reserve.
Stop by our offices on Bay Tree Road. It'll be our pleasure to serve you.
This is Bart Bosch. Oftentimes, people get the notion that the only way to get the best deal on a new vehicle is to drive hundreds of miles out of town. Now, at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, we make this pledge to our customers. We will meet or beat any competitor's price for a new Oldsmobile, Buick, GMC truck, or new Isuzu. Now you can be assured without trips to Jacksonville, Tallahassee, or wherever, you'll get the best deal at Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu on any model, any day, any time. Bosch Owens Buick GMC Isuzu, North Valdosta Road.
On the first play after the timeout, Baker's going to throw it as hard as he can down the field, and it lands harmlessly down at the 5-yard line, and that will be the last play of the first half, and the Blazers go off the field and get a nice hand from the homecoming crowd after 2 quarters of play. Your score, Valdosta State University 28, Mississippi College
21. John Lastinger will have your halftime show, and we'll be back for halftime after this 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Out of the billions and billions of numbers out there, 46 of them are headed our way. So if you'd like to play Lotto Georgia, visit a lottery retailer displaying the...
President Emeritus and Professor Emeritus of History at Valdosta State guided the institution through a period of rapid growth and development from 1966 until 1978. During his tenure, much of the present physical plant was constructed and many new academic programs added. In recognition of his and Mrs. Martin's outstanding contributions to the development of Valdosta State University, President Bailey is presenting Dr. Martin with a special university medallion. We are pleased to honor Dr. and Mrs. Martin on this homecoming Saturday. Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The Department of Music at Valdosta State University is proud to present for your listening and viewing pleasure the Valdosta State University Blazing Brigade. Of Drum Major Jason Hilliard, the Blazing Brigade opens this afternoon's show with the sounds of the immortal Duke Ellington and the big band hit Caravan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Valdosta State University Blazing Brigade. Thank you. Brigade closes its portion of the halftime show by featuring our lovely auxiliary groups performing to the Andrews Sisters hit, Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Please stand now and join in the singing of the Valdosta State University alma mater, conducted by Mr. Mark Belsick, Director of University Bands. And now we would like to recognize the 1993 homecoming candidates. Miss Becky Barnett, sponsored by Pi Kappa Phi Fraternity and escorted by Mr. Richard Scobie. Miss Ginger Beatty is sponsored by the Campus Activities Board and escorted by Mr. Ronald Beatty. Miss Allison Clark, sponsored by the Baptist Student Union and escorted by Mr. Alton Clark. Miss Marlene Dunbar is sponsored by Zeta Tau Alpha Sorority and escorted by Mr. James Dunbar. Miss Christine Folsom, sponsored by Sigma Alpha Iota and escorted by Mr. David Van Wyk. Miss Megan Gorman is sponsored by the Student Government Association and escorted by Mr. Bill Miller. Miss Marcy Hobbs, sponsored by the VSU Red Cross and escorted by Mr. Harold Hobbs. Miss Amy Morris is sponsored by Delta Chi Fraternity and escorted by Mr. Tony Morris. Miss Adriana Adderley is sponsored by the Society of International Students and escorted by Mr. Anthony Powell. Miss Sissy Anderson is sponsored by Alpha Delta Chi Sorority and escorted by Mr. John Alexander. Miss Stephanie Gooden, sponsored by the Black Student League and escorted by Mr. Stephen Gooden. Miss Nicole Flasky is sponsored by Kappa Alpha Order and escorted by Mr. Michael Smith. Miss Christy Linus, sponsored by Kappa Delta Sorority and escorted by Mr. Bob Linus. Miss Teresa McCann is sponsored by the Blazer Girls and escorted by Mr. Bill McCann. Miss Leanne Passmore, sponsored by the Political Science Club and escorted by Mr. Andy Cooper. Miss Ashley Pyman is sponsored by the Wesley Foundation and escorted by Reverend Andy Pyman. Miss Michelle Rose, sponsored by Pi Alpha and escorted by Mr. Ron Rose. Miss Jennifer Robinson is sponsored by Phi Mu Fraternity and Sigma Alpha Epsilon Fraternity and escorted by Mr. Kent Rebel. Miss Julie Seal, sponsored by Pi Omega Sorority and escorted by Mr. Mike Seal. Miss Sonia Sellers is sponsored by the VSU Ambassadors and escorted by Mr. Jerry Sellers. Miss Stephanie Van Hook, sponsored by the Blazing Brigade and escorted by Mr. Don Van Hook. Miss Danielle Zagari is sponsored by Pi Kappa Epsilon Fraternity and escorted by Mr. Greg Spencer. The homecoming court was voted on by the student body on Tuesday of this week. The court consists of the five girls receiving the most voters during the election. Flowers will be presented to the homecoming court by Mr. Uday Echo, President of the Student Government Association. The 1993 homecoming court in alphabetical order is as follows. Adriana Adderley. Stephanie Gooden, Nicole Klosky, and Christy Linus. On Thursday of this week, the student body selected a homecoming queen from this court. And now we present the 1993 homecoming queen, Miss Adriana Adams.
Time remaining in the ball game.
2.5 minutes to play in the football game, and the Blazers up by 14. Hatch is in the gun, standing at the MC 15-yard line. Dominic Ross on his left. Three wideouts on the left side. That's taking a long time with the snap count. 10 seconds still on the 25-second play clock. Now he's going to move Reggie Walker over to the right side. Looking to Dominique Ross. Now he's got time to throw. Wide open. Flash at the three to the two. Oh, Flash, he lost his footing just a bit, John. He wanted to get in the end zone so bad, and he lost his footing right at the three. He could have slipped in there. The man who made the stop on Flash Flanders with Keith Martin, the senior from McMinnville, Tennessee.
Yeah, nice job by us. We heard the Blazer coaches screaming next door. I think they saw Flanders open the whole time. But Chris Hatcher didn't find him until a little bit late, but got it to him, got a first down, and that's a big play to keep the drive going.
It certainly is, and Hatcher now has a chance to throw another touchdown pass, or will he stay on the ground, or will he take it himself? We've seen him take it himself on the naked bootleg a couple of times this year. Hatcher poised for glory at the goal line. First and goal at the three, goes left side to Ross, over the top, touchdown! The fullback from Jacksonville takes it in, and the Blazers lead it 41-21 over Mississippi College.
Great play there. You see a little bit of Dominique Ross's athletic ability. Looked like another guy I used to know about up in Athens town.
And it's hitting it off to a couple of times.
Going over the top there. Great job.
Here's the kick by Vernon Lorie to try to make it 42-21. Mark Beach is the holder. Snap is a good one. Kick is up, and it is good. Blazers 42, Mississippi College 21. We'll take a 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
You'll find them in communities throughout the nation. People in all walks of life, working in all types of jobs, doing what they can to get ahead. And while the scenery may change from small town to big city, these people have all the borrowing advantages of a major financial center because they live in one of the communities served by Nations Bank, giving Bob Todd in Abbeville, South Carolina, all the loan options he might find in New York, providing families like the Haleys in Annapolis, Maryland, the latest in home improvement and auto financing. And with loans exceeding $23 billion in just the last year, Nations Bank has helped nearly 3 million people like you reach their dreams. So whether you live in Fort Worth, Texas, Fort Myers, Florida, or any of the 1,900 other communities throughout our nation, finding the right loan can be as easy as talking with the people at Nations Bank, the loan source.
Equal housing lender, credit subject to approval.
Mike Jason, John Lastinger back on a gray Saturday afternoon, except for the scoreboard, and it's all lit up with Blazer points, 42 of them, to 21 for the visitors from Cleveland, Mississippi. Check that from Clinton, Mississippi. We'll go to Cleveland next
week.
That's
right. You're getting a little ahead of yourself there. Chris Hatcher with that last completion, 480 yards passing today.
To set another single-game record for VSU football, Dillard with a kickoff, line drive. Picked up at the 20-yard line. To the 25, to the 27, to the 28-yard line, and a flag down on the play. Flag down on the play. Turn was by MC's Bobby Williams.
Well, let's see. Find it. If I was a betting man, I'd probably say this would go into the Blazers, but well, let's see. Now we're going to get a holding call on Mississippi College, and that'll push him back. Nice. Good to see Shadrick Green back on the field, Mike. Limped off, thought he was... Thought he might be seriously injured there, but went down on the kickoff. He's limping a little bit, but good to know he's not hurt too seriously.
Absolutely. So that is a holding call against MC. Spot the ball back at the 19-and-a-half-yard line, so that's worst field position easily they've had all afternoon. They had glorious field position for most of this homecoming football game.
Well, let's see what they elect to do. They don't like to be put in a situation where they've got to throw it from first down on, but if they got any chance of making this thing interesting, they're going to have to throw it.
Here's Brad Strom back in at quarterback, three-step drop, throws the screen on the left side to Glover. Glover to the 18, tries to get to the 20, and he will not get there as the black shirts just swarm all over him, led by Erasmus Harvey and Edward Mitchell. Andre Randall also there. The play is going to pick up maybe a foot, maybe not. It's second and 10 right at the 20.
Good job by the Blazer defenders. Linebackers and secondary want to keep everything in front of them. Don't want anything going over their heads.
And the clock will run, and that's what the Blazers wanted to do, leading big time here, 42-21. Blazers come into the football game, averaging 44.4 points per contest, third in the nation. Brad Strom is going to give it up to his running back out of the backfield to the 24-yard line. And that is Kevin Blackman. And in there to make the stop for VSU is Reggie West. Blackman carries it to the 24, and he'll be 6 yards short of the first down. Third and six at the 24. And it will be. That's the end of the football game. Just like that, ends, just like that, it's all over at Cleveland Field. Blazers win it 42-21 over Mississippi College. We'll take a 60-second local break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
We're in the store once again here at Nijim's Diamonds and Gold. And fellas, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
That's right, Bob. We're geared up for a lot of merchandise. Right now, we have a large diamond sale and a gold sale going on. We have a 1-carat tennis bracelet for just $1.99. We have a 2-carat diamond, ruby, sapphire, and emerald bracelet for $1.99. And that means at Nijim's, you can put anything on layaway and layaway now for Christmas.
Nijim's Diamonds and Gold.
Nijim's Diamonds and Gold, Valdosta and Lake Park.
It's such a pleasant surprise to shop at the Framing Workshop. Hello, this is Carla Penny from the Framing Workshop, here to remind you of all the exquisite things we have to offer that you might not think about for a frame shop. We have hand-carved pens and boxes, clocks and journals, gift books, miniature gardens, and the most outstanding collection of photo frames for your tabletops that you'll ever see. Get your Hallusion 3D images here, too. The Framing Workshop at Barclay Square by the mall.
Prepare yourself for an extraordinary.
Mike Chasen and John Lasting are back at Cleveland Field. Hal Mummy standing right at the 50-yard line, congratulating all his players, and I'm sure congratulating the MC coaching staff, Terry McMillan, and his fine people who made the long trip from Clinton, Mississippi, only to lose to the Blazers 42-21, but it certainly did not look like it was going to happen early, as the Blazers had a 21-7 hole to dig themselves out of. John, comments on the game.
Well, let us take a look at the scoring summary. You kind of get an idea of what happened. Choctaw's got on the board first, 7:22 remaining in the first quarter. Jay Bourne, the fullback, from 1 yard out. That capped a 25-yard drive, so you see they started with great field position. McGinn, the point after, 7-0 Mississippi College. Again in the first quarter on a play, Blazers look like they had a sack, but Baker hits Kevin Blackman on a little screen pass, and he turns it into a 38-yard touchdown. The point after failed. It was 13-0. Blazers got cranked up at that point. Chris Hatcher to David Banks on a 4-yard touchdown pass. A great play by Chris Hatcher, his 27th of the year. Vernon Lowry, the point after, 13-7. Now Mississippi College comes right back with an 82-yard kickoff return, and then didn't take them long. Second play of the second quarter, Brad Strom to Kevin Blackman from 1 yard out. They went for two, made it. It's 21-7 MC. Well, that point on, the Blazers really poured on the steam on offense. It was Chris Hatcher to Stanley Fanders from 5 yards out in the second quarter. His 28th touchdown pass of the season. Vernon Lowry, the point after, 21-14, Mississippi College. Again, Chris Hatcher comes back on a beautiful strike to Stanley the Flash Flanders from 30 yards out. Vernon Lowry, the point after, we're tied at 21. And then with just a minute or so left in the first half, Chris Hatcher to Sean Pender from 1 yard out. Point after is good. It's 28-21. Third quarter, the only scoring Chris Hatcher to Steve Greer on a deflected pass from 4 yards out. That was his 31st touchdown pass of the season. Point after was good. It was 35-21. And then late in the ballgame, Dominic Ross from 1 yard out capped a nice drive by the Blazers. Vernon Lowry, the point after, to make the final 42-21.
We're going to be back with more in the postgame after this 60-second network break. This is the Blazers Sports Network.
Prepare yourself for an extraordinary new rotisserie chicken, deeply marinated with herbs and spices, then slowly roasted till golden brown. Is it from KFC? Indeed. The legendary long-lost recipe.